So atrial fibrillation is one of the most common arrhythmias of the heart. Normally your heart beats between 60 and 100 beats per minute, and it's very regular. So if you feel your pulse at your neck or at your wrist, you'll feel it's going very regularly. With atrial fibrillation, it's going all over the place, and it's usually going quite fast, more than 100 beats per minute. That's not really that harmful in and of itself, but if the blood's not flowing nicely, you can form a clot, usually in your heart, and that can go somewhere. If it goes to your brain, it can cause a stroke. But fortunately, there's excellent medication out there to prevent that from happening, drastically reducing the risk of having a stroke. Those are called anticoagulants, so they're blood thinners, really. You might have heard of warfarin, and now there's other anticoagulants on the market that will do the same thing for you. Well, we know that there's many patients in the community who are not on appropriate anticoagulation to prevent them from having a stroke. That's probably because blood thinners make people nervous, both physicians and the patients. So around a third, maybe more, of these patients who should be taking anticoagulation to prevent them from having a stroke are not taking it. We also know from research that we've done here at ICES that many of these patients show up in the emergency department at some time because they have shortness of breath or heart palpitations or chest pain. Where would you go if you had those symptoms? Of course, they go to the ER. So we have a real opportunity to increase the number of patients who are on appropriate anticoagulation in the ER. So that's why I wanted to do this study, because my thinking was, I bet if we start it in the ER, if I give a patient a prescription when they're scared and their heart's been racing, it's probably much more influential than if I say, see your family doctor, it's 2 weeks before they get to see them, and they felt fine the whole time. They didn't have a stroke, and now you tell me you want me to be on a blood thinner for the rest of my life. So I think we have a real teachable moment in the ER. That was my hypothesis going in, and that's why I did the study. So we looked at patients who were discharged from 15 ERs in Ontario, and all of these patients were sent home. They weren't admitted to hospital, and they all were given a diagnosis of atrial fibrillation. All of them were over the age of 65, and they all qualified for stroke prevention therapy with anticoagulation. We even removed patients who are a little bit higher risk of bleeding, like patients from a nursing home or who have cancer. So we ended up with a cohort of patients, just over 2,000 of them, who truly have no excuses to not have oral anticoagulation to prevent stroke. So of the 2,132 patients who were in the study, we found that almost 20% were given a prescription in the ER. And then we looked 6 months later to see, of those patients, how many were still taking a prescription for oral anticoagulation to prevent a stroke. That was 67%, or two-thirds of those patients. When we looked at the patients who were sent to their family doctor to start it with the family doctor or cardiologist or internist, we found that only 37% of those patients were taking it 6 months later. So that's an absolute increase of 30%, and that's a pretty big number. Another interesting finding we had was that it varied greatly by which ER you were seen in. So some ERs, 7% of patients got a prescription for oral anticoagulation. Up to 38% of the patients in another ER got a prescription for oral anticoagulation. So really, it's not so much about the patient and their risks as about the ER that you're seen in and the practice that happens, the practice patterns in that ER. It's not standardized, clearly. And then the other interesting finding was, my initial hypothesis was that this would be a very influential thing with patients if I hand them a prescription for oral anticoagulation in the ER during that visit. And in fact, we found that the majority of patients filled that prescription within a day of leaving the ER. So that does suggest that it's highly influential with patients. Well, as an ER physician, we all want to have long-term impact on our patients. We see them briefly, and here's an opportunity where you could have long-term impact by preventing a stroke down the line. And this study shows that at 6 months' time, your prescription has had an impact. So I think the new way going forward is we should initiate oral anticoagulation in the ER for this particular medication, because we have evidence that it makes a difference in the long term.